Hi friends, it's Waleed here and welcome to Creative Skills. Today I am going to teach you guys the use of crop tool. Many of you guys are already familiar with this tool and you often use it in different software and apps, but Photoshop crop tool is a very powerful tool. In my previous Photoshop basic series tutorial, I have explained some basic commands of Photoshop. If you didn't watch that tutorial, the link is on the top right corner of the screen, or you can also check the link in the descriptions below. I have arranged all my Photoshop basic series tutorial one by one chronologically. You should check other tutorials to increase your knowledge about Photoshop. Let's move to the Photoshop. I have already opened some images in Photoshop and the tool that is selected is the move tool. Now I want to crop these two glasses from the image. I'll simply go to the toolbar and select the crop tool, or I can also press the shortcut key for crop tool is C. When I select the crop tool, the crop marquee appears around the image, or I can simply drag the cursor on the image and select the subject that I want to crop. The juice glasses selected, I can also adjust the crop marquee with the handle, or I can press the shift key to crop from both axes, or I can press the alt and shift key to crop the image in same proportion and then press enter or click on the tick sign. Right now, I do not want to crop the image. Therefore, I'll simply go to the history panel and click on the image icon. If your history panel is not appearing here, you can simply go to the window menu and select the history option. The history panel will appear here. Here are some of the options that will show you. First is the ratio when we crop the image. These boxes will appear. This is in the ratio form, and if we crop the image with respect of width, height and resolution, we can simply select this option. And if the ratio is selected, we can easily type the ratio. We want to crop the image with the width of 1280 pixel and the height is 768. Then that area is selected. For example, I want to define my own width, height and resolution. I'll simply select the high width, height and resolution and type here my width, for example 1200 by 550. This is the size I want to save, and the resolution of the image is 300 pixels. I can also swap the width, height, and for example, I'll click on the two arrow button with the width of the image is 500 pixel and the height of the image will 1200 pixel. I'll swap it again and I want to save this crop preset. Let me save to a new crop preset. And then press the OK button. The preset saved. If I want to reset the crop area of the image, click on the ratio and go to the history panel and click on the original image icon. And the ratio I set to be original ratio. This is the original ratio of the image. Now I want that size which we have selected before. I'll simply click on the preset which we have saved. That image area will select again and press the tick sign, the image crop. Let me zoom in for the image. For now we do not crop the image. Therefore I'll zoom out and click on the history panel and select the original image. And then press Ctrl 0 key to fit on my screen here. I'll click on the clear button. All of these options will clear. The crop tool is selected right now, but there is no crop marquee appear on the image because If I'll click on the image, the crop marquee will appear again, and then I'll go to the rule of thirds. The selection is right now rule of thirds. We can also see it in the grid view, or we can see it in the diagonal lines, or we can see it in the diagonal form, or we can also cycle these views by selecting cycle overlay. We can also cycle these overlays by O key. When we press the O key, all the views cycle one by one. For right now, we will select the rule of thirds and then select the auto show overlay option. If we select the auto show overlay, all the grids will high. Okay, and if we click on the image, the grid will show again. And if we release the button, the grid will hide again. And if we start never show overlay, no any overlay will show on the image. We will go with the default always show overlay and go ahead. And next is the setting banner. First option is the use classic mode. This is the old mode, which was earlier Photoshop version used for now, and check this option. Second option is show cropped area. For example, I have cropped this area and zoom out the image and click on the option show cropped area unchecked. All the unselected area will hide. And if I will click check it again, and in the all image will show. And this is the auto center preview. This option will allow me to center my crop area. And this is the opacity, and the opacity is the area which will crop. If the opacity will be set to be something like 50, the image will clearly show. If I set it to 1%, all the image will clearly show, and the crop area is in the crop marquee. I'll set it to 75% as it is by default. And after that, this option is the delete crop pixels. The unselected area is the pixels. And when I check it and press the enter key, all the image which is not selected is cropped. I'll select the move tool and unlock the layer and move to the image. All the unselected pixels removed. Therefore, this is not the proper way. I'll go with the original image again and select the crop tool and crop it again in the area of the image. And for this time, uncheck the delete crop pixels. I'll uncheck this and press enter. Now, the image cropped. And the original image is not distracting. We can easily reposition the image, or we can easily rotate it. In this way, our image will not distract. And if we export this image as JPEG, the showing area will export as JPEG format only. And if we want to save this image as PSD format, the complete all image will save as PSD. Right now, we will go to the original image. Here, I have another image of the car. And here, I want to straighten this car. I'll simply go to the crop tool. And here, from the option bar, I'll select the straighten option. And click on the image and drag it to the right. And release my mouse. The car automatically straightened. It is so simple and easy. Or you can also drag the image with the curve arrow to reposition the car. I'll simply select the car and press OK or Enter. The car straightened. These are some uses of crop tool in Photoshop, and I hope you have learned something from this tutorial. And if you want to ask anything regarding to this tutorial, please comment us in the comment section. We will reply you as soon as possible. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Stay connected with us. See you in the next tutorial. Thanks for watching.